Sup nerds, I'm Brickner here, and welcome to another Call of Duty Black Ops 2 gameplay commentary. I didn't say anything weird this time. Who knew that was coming? I did, because I plan things before I say them. Not really. Kind of like now. Okay, so that's a sufficiently weird intro. Party games, that's what I'd like to talk about today. This is another party game. This is Sharpshooter on the map Hijacked. This was a pretty funny game. We got a couple snipers, and then we got like the Pack-a-Punch, or not Pack-a-Punch, what the fuck am I talking about? This is not zombies. We got Akimbo Executioners, and then we got like the Ballistic Knife, and then we just got the Combat Knife back-to-back, so it was just like retard fight knife fights like forever. Epic Swallow, so that was pretty funny. And yeah, so I win this game, obviously. I kill 37 people, and I only die 10 times, and I'm obviously Grizz Baby. I just pop these guys with the snipers. But I just think... it's... Something about party games I notice is that I win 99% of the time because, like, this is going to sound really cocky, but I'm better than all these retards, and it's because it's just gun on gun. There's no BS. It's me, my gun, and they can't take me because I am the king, baby. All hail the king. I actually suck, but that's because people who play party games are generally retards. But the point being is that in, like, Ground War and stuff, like, I die from, like, stupid shit, like, bouncing Bettys and, like, snipers like hiding and campers and stuff, and like in this it's just gun on gun and I'm clearly superior to them. And yeah, party games are fun. I enjoy them. I think, you know, I've done a lot of Ground War games kinda, and I don't really get that many impressive gameplays, like crazy impressive like amp gameplays. So, you know, I think these party games like are a nice change of pace. I like playing them. I think they're kind of entertaining to watch because it's like, what's gonna happen? Maybe I should get some closer ones, because I mean it's not really that suspenseful, because obviously I'm gonna win every time. I'm Amp Reckoner. I mean, look at me go, just camping this spawn and waiting for the radar to show me exactly where they are. So I mean, yeah, I think party games are pretty cool. I think they're a testament of skill. And you know, if I ever feel like doing a quick commentary like this, I'll just grab a party game and then toss it up here. I'll keep playing Ground War and trying to go for like cool gameplays, but I don't know, I'm just Black Ops 2, those are getting a little boring for me. They're getting a little old. I think these are zany. I'm a zany person, and I'm a zany channel. You know, I feel like people are here on my channel for zaniness, not for, like, amazing gameplays. Here because, you know, I give you a boner, and, you know, confetti's in the air. Everyone's just having a good time. It's a party on Amp Reckoner's channel. So, yeah, that's what I wanted to say. Party games, they're very fitting for me. I kick ass at them because they take skill, and I'm a party channel. Party games. Yeah. So, I'm gonna go play hockey right now. That's the plan. It's really sunny. I love this time of the year where it's, I guess when I'm recording this, it's March 9th. It'll be up on March 9th too. Unless, like, the internet gets shut down where Obama's like, yeah, we've decided to shut down the internet. Porn, the video games, they're bad for the youth. And then everyone's like, what, come on, Obama, we like the internet. So that's probably unlikely to happen, but if the internet does get shut down, then I won't upload this video today. But it probably will be uploaded on March 9th. And where I live in Abbotsford, BC, Canada, the sun is shining. It's been a long, hard winter, but here comes the sun. Doo-doo-doo-doo. Here comes the sun, I say, it's alright. Doom, 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 doom. Yeah, that was my George Harrison impression. The Beatles are really awesome. I love the Beatles. So anyways, the sun is shining. I'm going to play hockey. It's going to be awesome. My Toronto Maple Leafs play the Pittsburgh Penguins later today. We take on Sid the Kid, Evgeny Malkin. We're probably going to lose, but the Leafs are actually, we're cruising. We're in fifth in the conference right now. We're playing good hockey. We're halfway through the season. I'm holding my breath. The Maple Leafs have missed the playoffs for seven straight seasons, and eight, including the original lockout that was before the seven seasons we missed. However, I have this theory, because we kicked ass, the Leafs were awesome, and then the lockout happened, and then we became terrible, and then seven seasons passed where we couldn't make the playoffs, and now this other lockout happened this past year, and maybe that's the signal for a new turnaround where we're going to become awesome again. Maybe the lockout is like the solstice of hockey and it triggers a change in everything to do with the Maple Leafs. Maple Leafs, it's like seasons kind of, right? The Leafs fall or the Leafs stay on the trees. The tree being a metaphor for the playoffs. This is what you call rambling. I'm definitely doing that right now. So I'm going to stop this commentary and I'm going to play hockey. I like to be the goalie. I'm a good goalie, I think. I don't think that. I know that. You have to believe you're the best to be the best. That's kind of my, I invented that line. And I hope you enjoyed this party on a boat with me killing people with my guns, and they don't have any bouncing Bettys to shield themselves. It's just me. They can't even take it. I dominated these guys, and I'm falling down.